So I'm trying to re-catch myself here and we'll make this time your worth your while. So the socio-economic consequences, what do we mean with this? What impact will this technology have on the social behavior of humans, the economical behavior on humans, and combine them, these two factors, the socio-economic consequences. So first of all, if we are talking about the change in trust, and if we're talking about new forms of scalable governance, and basically recreating or creating the structure of our future social and economical networks, what we need more than ever are ethics, ladies and gentlemen. We need ethics. If we start structuring the economics, which are limited, of course, by our own bias, because we encode our bias in this new economical social highway, we need to have ethics. A very good example of this are, for example, the automated cars of a Tesla, where you actually now, for the very first time in history, need to encode a certain decision that that car is going to make. So imagine this example where you are behind the wheels of a Tesla, and this Tesla is on a self-driving modus. This Tesla is programmed in such a way that it needs to protect the life of the driver in all ways, which is a logical choice. But what happens if a red ball bounces in front of your car? The car evades it because it needs to save your life, or it runs over this ball. But what happens if a small child jumps after this ball? The car will actually run over the child, because that statistically gives you the huge amount, or give you a higher chances of surviving than when it defects the child. Is that an ethical decision? For the first time in human history, you actually need to program that car to make that decision. So you might end up having two types of cars. You might have Tesla egoism, which will go straight over the child and save the life of you as a driver. Or you might have Tesla altruism, which basically saves the life of the child and gives you a decreased percentage of surviving that crash. We need to program this stuff. We need to think about this. And we need, more importantly, need to discuss this among each other with people who spent entirely studies on it. We shouldn't let this be coded by people who didn't give it a second thought, because they could technically do it, but didn't thought about the consequences. It's very important that we have a very good balanced way of ethics, of techniques, of creativities, of artists, of men, women, cultural backgrounds. We need to have a balanced flavor. It's very dangerous if you leave this in the hands of a small select group who just know how to write codes and know how these algorithms work. So luckily, we already see a lot of good initiatives starting in this regard. We see ethics getting increasingly more and more important. So hopefully, and us humans knowingly, we will be in time. The second time, first we will screw up, then we will discover that we screwed up, then we will do it again, we will screw up again, and we will keep increasing these forms of ethics. Only problem though is that this time you might actually think of it in advance, because it saves you a lot of time and effort in advance cleaning up your mess. So ethics is going to be a very important one. Also, socio-economic economic consequences, you could not, unless you've lived under a rock, you most likely heard either about blockchain or about Bitcoin in the end of 2017. You most likely read many, many different things about what is this technology. I always got asked, blockchain, that's a scam, right? That doesn't work, right? How does it work? So I honestly gave up that conversation, because you can't keep on explaining everything over and over again. So this was my solution. Try to explain it one more time, then refer people to these movies. A lot of hype, a lot of media, a lot of uncertainty. Importantly is that you have the, well, not an obligation, of course, but you have, if you want to learn more about it, that's the beauty. There are tremendous amounts of information. And of course, we're going to dissect this information and discuss this in next topic. So that was not really an interesting one. What I wanted to say is that you can compare this technique with the internet of the beginning of the 90s. It shows a lot of possibilities, but of course, a lot of errors. The articles that are written about blockchains are equally in the same distributed timeline as they were written about the internet. So first they harassed the internet, that it was used by criminals, and now they did the exact same thing with blockchains, and then they tried to build the intranet. Now they want to build the centralized blockchains. So you see the same movements, you see the same timeline. And of course, where internet is used to transfer information, blockchains are used to transfer value. So thanks to blockchain, you now have the internet of value, and we can actually start transacting information and value combined. Very interesting times, very many, many possibilities. So open public blockchains create commons. So we hope that we will see a rise of commons. So a common pool of resources that we can use as humanity. So where we can use the internet in a more centralized fashion, we will hopefully create a Web 3.0 or open finance or sound money or other institutions created by humans for humans. So not for centralized parties, not to increase bigger wallets, to create even bigger wallets or gain more control over people. No, actually for the people. Just like the air we breathe is free, so are these services we use are free. Well, nearly free, of course, because we need to pay for miners in security. Depending on what you're paying, use case, different blockchain. It's an insurance policy for many people around the world for an Orwellian future. More than 50% lives under a totalitarian, I am going to nail it one day, totalitarian regime. And here kicks in my brainwave, and then I will finish this section off. As you may have noticed, I'm quite fatigued. We're talking about predictable behavior already. Where it gets interesting, actually, let me rephrase it. There actually nowadays is a Bitcoin suit where your body, by movement of your body, you create energy. And by creating that energy, you actually start mining. So by human energy, or energy created by human activity, you are sustaining a decentralized network that can be shut down. So it's basically feeding on human energy. If, of course, everybody would wear a Bitcoin suit, then you could actually run something like that. So here it gets interesting. If you let run loose an algorithm that's very smart on a network like that, you actually removed all the thresholds, so it can run across the globe. Nothing can stop it because it's an unstoppable ledger. There's actually incentive to keep the network alive. And it's smarter than us humans. You can create something either beautiful or something very dangerous. Remember the ethics, right? So hopefully no military algorithms, no commercial algorithms, right, that are letting loose upon this world. So hopefully the developers with a good heart get there first, instead of the commercial type of algorithms. I'm not a big fan of those. In other words, we can steer some certain direction, and we can create a world without thresholds, without boundaries of countries, without limitations, where information is freely accessible for a algorithm that can actually predict behavior and analyze behavior before it even happens, knows you better than you do. Imagine a world where you are virtually connected. I think that sounds a lot like worlds like the Matrix, like Skynet, if you program these worlds in the wrong direction. We now have the power to create entirely new worlds that live outside this physical world. And since we are already migrating more and more into a digital realm, we really need to think very well about the consequences. We really need to think twice before we start building stuff. And that's always, of course, why we need more balanced ecosystems. So whether you have no IT technical background, where you don't feel like a mathematical prodigy, we sincerely, from the bottom of my heart, we do need you strongly. There is much, much, much more value in this world than you give yourself credit. We need your opinion, we need your vision, we need your power, your energy, we need everything you have to offer, because we want to build commons for the better. It's tremendously hard to recreate a world like this after it's been created. It might even take another 1500 years to reinvent this world. So please bear with us and use this knowledge you now have. Use this education we offer and apply yourself. In other words, you actually have a chance and choice here to build for the commons and use your energy and mind power and all your network for the better. So help us in our quest. Help us recreate a better world, or help us recreate the commons. And do this by clicking on next course. That's all you need to do. And start building towards a more decentralized, fairer world with sharing economies, circular economies, peer-to-peer economies, which are more sustainable for the world, which are more sustainable for you and me and for our children. Let's do it, you and I together. I'm getting a bit out of hand, a bit passionate here. So I will now sincerely, from the bottom of my heart, hope that you will be there in the next session. If not, I hoped I enjoyed educating you. If you have any questions, any remarks, if you didn't like my jibber jabber in the end, or if you liked it at all, let us know in the comments. I dare you to challenge us regarding the topics we treated. If you missed anything, let us know in the Slack as well. I will see you in next session. For now, I'm going to tune out. I am taking these puppies home and I will go to my children and I am going to build a better future for them. I hope I am, and I hope that you will join me as well. See you in next course.